This is the current prototype of the Pixel Planes graphics system at the Microelectronic Systems Laboratory of UNC Chapel Hill's Department of Computer Science. The system rapidly generates realistic, smooth-shaded images of three-dimensional objects and scenes. The machine's simplest software executes a Z-buffer visible surface algorithm from a scene description stored in a conventional display list. The only unusual aspect here is that the description of each polygon is broadcast into the frame buffer, and all the pixel-level processing is done by the custom so-called smart frame buffer. That is, there is no rendering engine outside the frame buffer that converts a polygon into pixels and then stores each pixel in a conventional frame buffer memory. The display list, its traversal, the geometric transformations, and the conversion to pixel planes commands are all handled by a pipeline of three commercially available array processors made by Mercury Systems. They are shown here on the top rack. The pixel planes commands are sent to 2048 custom memory chips residing on 32 frame buffer memory boards. Each board contains 64 custom chips. Each chip contains memory and processing for 128 pixels. The heart of the system is this cluster of custom frame buffer memory chips, which perform calculations in parallel at every pixel with very little dedicated circuitry. Each chip contains, in addition to the usual pixel memories, a 1-bit arithmetic logic unit for each pixel and a binary tree of 1-bit adders that can rapidly evaluate linear expressions in the screen's X and Y coordinates for every pixel in the chip simultaneously. Fortunately, many pixel calculations turn out to be of this form, that is, linear in the screen space. Calculations of this form are very efficient in the system, since for them, only the linear coefficients A, B, and C, and their operation codes, need to be broadcast to memory chips. Each of these chips has a multiplier tree to calculate the expression AX plus BY plus C, and so only simple bit operations need to be done at the individual pixel level. A convex polygon can be rendered by broadcasting to the frame buffer the linear coefficients for each edge and having it turn off all pixels that are outside of that edge. All the pixels are on at the start of the polygon, and with each edge, more and more pixels get turned off until at the end, only those pixels inside the polygon are still on. Hidden surface calculations using the classic Z-buffer algorithm are also done simultaneously for all pixels in a polygon using a single ABC linear coefficient set. These are the coefficients of the plane on which this polygon lies. Each pixel compares its new value that it receives from the multiplier tree with the old Z value that it's storing in the Z buffer. Shadows can also be calculated efficiently with linear expressions. Note that the shadows of one object can drape naturally onto and around other objects. They are not simple polygons painted only on the ground. The shadows are now being turned on and off for emphasis. A scene with shadows is calculated in about twice the time of the same scene without shadows. Here we show an extreme close-up of the screen to demonstrate our first anti-aliasing method. The staircasing artifacts are minimized by successive refinement over sampling whenever the system has spare time. That occurs whenever the user stops moving the object. At these times, the system continues to calculate additional samples within each pixel and filtering appropriately. Whenever the user is moving the object, however, the system abandons anti-aliasing in the interest of speed. Circles are displayed essentially as polygons with one edge, because the nonlinear terms x squared plus y squared are constant and are pre-stored in each pixel. This technique, suggested by Fred Brooks, allows the system to rapidly display molecular models like these. Here are two molecules with over 1,000 atoms. Notice that they can be independently controlled and can pass through each other without difficulty. In fact, we would sometimes like to prevent objects like these two from passing through each other, and so have started to work on interference checking, so-called bump checking, to further help the user understand how two molecules like this large protein and the small drug can fit together. Notice that the light source can also be moved interactively, as seen here, moving from left to right. Here is an image processing application using Steve Pizer's adaptive histogram equalization technique being applied to a CT scan cross-section of a human patient's chest. The number of intensity levels in the data is much greater than the number that can be discerned on any video display. So normally, it's very difficult to see detail in both the dense bony areas and also detail in the soft tissue. This technique you see being executed in a few seconds on pixel planes takes about 1.5 hours on a VAX 11 780. We toggle here between the original and the final image to allow you to compare the apparent detail in both the bony areas, like the spine near the bottom of the image, and the lungs that take up most of the middle. This is reconstructed anatomy from dozens of cross-sectional CT scans of a patient at North Carolina Memorial Hospital. We see the skin of the torso with some bones inside. Radiation therapists are working with these reconstructions in hopes of improving the effectiveness of their therapy plans. We remove the skin to reveal the pelvic bones and some organs.